question is by S_Ayush. He asks us, what is your opinion about the new Nexus, the Marlin, and the Sailfish? How will they fare against iPhone 7? So, thing is that there are rumors that the Nexus, Marlin, and the Sailfish would be made by HTC or Google. If these are made by Google, then these would be absolute spot on. But if it's made by HTC, then we have no comments on about it. iPhone 7, the 90% of the iPhone 7 model has been leaked.
There are many rumors going on with iPhone 7, so there's nothing much to talk about. We can just wait for it to release and then we will give you our thoughts and our impressions after trying it out. Not after buying it, in fact, just trying it. Can't really afford it. So
the next question is from
Dheeraj13. He is asking about information about Google's Project Ara. Yeah. So Google's Project Ara is basically modular smartphones. Modular smartphones, as you all know, it is going on from a pretty long time. They are almost to end it. And as on Google I/O 2016, they said they will be releasing it this fall, as in it can come out anytime. It's real soon. It's just time that it can come out and you people can buy it. It's not 100% sure when they will come out with it, but sure, it will come real soon. So it's modular smartphone basically. Next question.
The next question is by Karthik2211. What is your opinion on Nvidia? My dream would be to get a Nvidia Quadro M6000, 12GB graphic card.
It's like, it's super expensive.
And super cool too.
It's just a dream.
Yeah.
Like, if we are to buy that graphics card and we'll edit our videos on that graphic card, it will be like this. Amazing, right? So the next question is by Hummingbird_Pro. What is the difference between Focusrite 2i2 and Focusrite 2i4? See, what I know, see, Hummingbird Pro is basically my friend, so I know what are his requirements. His requirements are to record guitar videos, right? He wants to become a YouTuber and he wants to record his guitar videos, what he plays. So for guitar, what Hummingbird Pro needs, Focusrite 2i2 is not recommended for guitars. It is moreover for people like us, like for voiceovers and to record things what we speak. Guitar tunes are more like altogether a different thing when you record. So for guitar, 2i4 is recommended. So Hummingbird Pro, go for
So the next question comes from Hunter69.
The name itself. Okay. Yeah, let's move on to the question.
Yeah. He asks us that, can you tell me about the new OnePlus 3? I mean, can you compare the new OnePlus 3 and the OnePlus 2? Absolutely, Hunter. The OnePlus 3 and OnePlus 2 are compared like this. According to the RAM, the OnePlus 3 has got 6GB of RAM, the OnePlus 2 has 4GB. The OnePlus 3 runs on Snapdragon 820 processor, and the OnePlus 2 runs on Snapdragon 810 processor. It has dash charge, like it charges your phone like just quickly.
In 30 minutes
you get a day's power
get day's power in 30 minutes.
Yeah, 30 minutes basically.
So they are not much comparable. They are from the same company.
Yeah.
And OnePlus 3 is a successor, okay? So you can't actually compare them. It's like a year's difference between both of them. So it has to be the hardware that's different. And basically with the hardware that you change, there are many software implementations which take place. So the OnePlus 3 is obviously better. But comparing the budget and all, then you can always go in for a OnePlus 2 if your budget doesn't allow you for the OnePlus 3. OnePlus 2 budget, or if you are in the price segment of 25 to 30,000 rupees, then 100% go for the OnePlus 3. It's a beast of a device. So the next question is by Mukul Gihani. Which do you think will be a better option, Redmi 3 or Lure 2? In case of hardware, Lure 2 is better. No doubt it has Snapdragon 652, whereas the Redmi 3, Redmi Note 3 in fact has Snapdragon 850 is yet to come, 650. But when it comes to software, as I said, software matters for the end user. It is my own experience with Xiaomi. The software has been amazing. I previously, last year in December or something, 2014 December or 2015 start, I had bought the Redmi 1S and it was a smooth device, it worked well. Then I switched to OnePlus 1, but I switched from a Redmi 1S to the OnePlus 1 like in March 2015 or something. That time the messages as in the text messages what came to me, my call log, my photos that I took, every single thing was transferred to the Redmi Note 3. When now I switched to the Redmi Note 3, a good device I would say. But as I was talking about the software, I had left it in March 2015 and now it is July 2016. It's like that period of time is not there. Rest, all of it is there intact from when I switched. Like even the call log, the messages, everything have come along as just I just signed into my MI account. Even the notes, every single thing has come to this Redmi Note 3 without any issue. It's like it's a seamless experience. You just have to log into your MI account and it's there.
So overall, in terms of software, we'd strongly recommend the Redmi Note 3.
Amazing. So moving on to the next question.
So here's a question on from a tech YouTuber, Dhananjay Bhosle. I'll give the link in the description down below.
A good friend of ours.
Yes. He asks us that, do you think that reviews are overdone on YouTube? Yes, actually they are done. Like gadgets that are just launched in the market and someone reviews it and says that I dislike
it within a day. Like how can you review it within a day? You
and
have
then,
not used it.
Yeah, and then give personal opinions on it without using it. So that is, I think, not correct.
Without even having your hands on the device. If the product is released in the international markets, like 3 months ago, let's take it 3 months ago, and then it comes to your country after 3 months, and then you review it on the same day that it is released in your country, then it's fine enough because you know how the device is performed to other users. Like if it is used by other users and you have seen how it works, then you can review it. But if you haven't,
unless and until you don't get hands on the device, you can't actually.
It's not only about hands on, it's experience by no one. But you are giving your opinion, that's wrong. Next question is by Arpit Panda, even a good friend of ours.
Which software do you use for editing? We use the Adobe Premiere Pro and Adobe
After Effects.
This video will be edited by that software only.
The next question is a bit personal, but it's for both of us. So Akash Javeri is asking, how much did you progress in Pokemon Go? So in Pokemon Go, he is on level
90
and I am on level 20. So that's what our progress is. It's a pretty addictive game, I must say. The next question, you can read it out.
Yeah, it's by it's a personal question for him by Aditya Gidh.
For Rajan's for life, basically. It's like 10 years compared to 2 years, not even 2 years completed, but more than 10 years in Rajan. So it's Rajan's for life, 100% Rajan's for life. Moving on to some funny questions. The first question is by Reggae underscore U, or what? again, there are many desserts starting with the same name, right? Like for N, they chose Nougat, but there was Naan Khatai as well. There are Indian sweets with the same names, what Android has released. So my request would be, if Google is watching this, start with A and first would be Amras. Amras is preferred by everyone, in India at least. So I don't know about the world, but yeah, I prefer it. So the last but not the least, the last question is by S_Ayush.
Okay.
Why did Katappa kill Bahubali?
Actually, you should check the second part, Bahubali. It will be coming in 2017 or 2016. Okay.
So till then, you hold on with this question. No. Hold on with this question. Answer this once the movie releases,
yeah.
And then in the next Q&A after the movie, this question would